In today's free Affinity Photo tutorial, I'm going to show you my full editing process of this RAW file, and we're going to get from this photo into this photo in no time, using only the developer persona and native Affinity Photo tool. So, if you want to come along for the ride, let's get started. Hello everybody, this is Strato Agiani from Illumius.com, the website and online academy / YouTube channel where we teach you how to create amazing photos using Affinity Photo. Each week we bring free tutorials like this one and we help you unlock your creative potential. So if you are new here, consider subscribing if you like what you see and if you want to hear my fun Greek accent all the way, all the time, always. Okay, let's dive into Affinity Photo. Now, I'm going to take the photo that I show you at the intro and I'm going to drop it into Affinity Photo. Just a little background story. During Kavala Air Sea Show, one of the air shows that happened here in my hometown, and I was really happy, lucky and proud to be part of the official photographer's team. And here we have an amazing shot of an Apache helicopter doing a very low flyby while I'm photographing the commander that is giving the instructions to the pilot on what he should perform next, okay? Really honored to be part of this amazing celebration of aviation and talent, and I'm going to show you how I edited this photo. Now, because this photo has a cinematic feel to it, I wanted to do a color grade that is more cinematic, so it's a little unconventional but very creative at the same time, and I'm going to explain what I mean in just a few seconds. But first of all, we need to bring this photo to a good level in order to be able to jump off from this level into our creative process. So we need to fix this photo. The first thing that I want to do is I want to go immediately to the shadows and highlights panel over here and drag the highlights to the left until I get more detail here in the sky. I can see more clouds and more color from the sky. Once I do something like this, I usually then like to go to exposure to bump up the exposure just a little bit. Okay. And in order to bring back some detail and contrast, I'm going to play with a black point and I'm going to push it slightly to the right to bring back some contrast to the photo. And maybe I will add some vibrance, just a little bit. And there you have it. Now, because I can see that the face is turning kind of reddish, doesn't look very good, maybe I will dive down the vibrance to around 2-3%. I'm going to click here to see the before and after. So this is a before, very flat, bright photo. This is the after, more contrast, more punch, more detail. And maybe, just maybe, add just a tiny bit of clarity, something let's say at 15%, just to bring things to the surface and let more details pop up. Maybe, I don't know, I'm going to the details panel, let's go to the detail refinement and play around with the radius and the amount, and this will give us just a tiny bit more detail to play around with. All right. As you can see, we are good to go. I don't need to do anything here. So I'm going to hit develop and I'm going to bring this photo into the main Affinity Photos environment, okay? Let me bump myself up just a little bit over here, all right? Now, what I want to do first of all is I want to create a base color. I want to create a base mood. And the best tool to do that for my purposes is the gradient map that you can find over here. If you click on this half filled circle, you're going to have this menu appear and you can select from here the gradient map adjustment. This is a non-destructive tool, meaning that if you screw up, you can erase this layer and you can start over without fear that you may or may not destroy your photo. Now I'm going to select the central point and hit the delete button to get rid of it. And I'm going to this point to the left. And because this is an army themed photo, I'm going to add some greens over here to the shadows. And I'm going to go to this circle over here. I'm going to left click it and click on the color. And I'm going again to give a greenish color tint over here. Green orange, let's say. And then I'm going to select the blending mode from normal into soft light, and I'm going to drop the opacity to around 25%. Okay, and now if you can see it, this is before, okay, and after, before and after. It has that cinematic greenish vibe to it that fits well with the subject. Now, if I want to make things more interesting, I can go over here on this green color, I can click here, and I can make this green color darker, so it doesn't appear so much into my face, okay? It is there, but it is subtle. It does its job without screaming, "Hey, I'm a green color, look at me," instead of the subject. I hope it makes sense. I'm going to do the same thing here. I'm going to click this control point with a color. I'm going to click into the color and drag the circle towards the black edge of this triangle, all right? Now, let's see, this is before and after, before and after. All right, now, step number two. I'm going over here to the curves adjustment, and I'm going to select from here the red channel. So I'm clicking here on the master option, and I'm selecting the red from the drop-down menu. And I want to go over here at the shadow area, so I'm going to left-click to create a new control point, and I'm going to drag this control point to the left. And as you can see, I am actually adding some red to the color, okay? And here I am reducing red from the shadows. But if I add some red to the shadows, it's going to give this nice hacky look to the whole photo. It looks more in tune with a military action film color grade, let's say, all right? So if you take this control point and drag it to the left, you're going to add the red to the shadows. If you drag it to the right, you're going to subtract red from the shadows, meaning that they will turn more green. So this is an okay look, but I prefer this a little better. All right. I think we are so far so good. Now the next thing is to fix the contrast. So I'm going to click over here and I'm going to select the curves adjustment layer once more. And as usual, I'm going to click here and here. This is where two lines intersect. So I'm clicking in this region. This is where these two lines intersect. So I'm clicking in this region as well to create these control points. Now I'm going to click and drag this to the right to make the shadows darker, and I'm going to click and drag this to the left to make the highlights slightly brighter. All right, this is a before without the contrast, after, before and after. Small but important change. Again, I'm going to click at the middle and I'm going to drag this control point that controls the highlights to the left and upwards to make it just a tiny bit brighter. Now, if you ask me, the face is becoming a little too red for my taste, okay? There is a lot of red in the face. So what I want to do is I want to go over here, select the selective color option, all right? I'm going to select the reds, which means it will affect only the red colors, what I'm about to do, and I'm going to drop the magenta, all right, slightly, because if you overdo it, you're going to get a Shrek Army Edition, which we don't want that. So I'm going to slightly drag it to the left. Same thing with yellows, just to get rid of this very yellowish tone. Okay, and you can play around with the cyan if you want until you get a decent cinematic skin tone. And I think this looks a lot better if you ask me. Now, if I take these layers and disable them, this is before, this is the original photo after the treatment we did in the developer persona, and this is the more cinematic version of it, all right? But we are not done. I'm going to do one small step. I'm going to go over here and select the amazing split toning tool, which allows me to add some color to the shadow areas and to the highlights or to the bright areas. So in the highlights, I'm going to add some blue. So I'm going to click somewhere around here to select the blue color that I want to add to the highlights. And then I'm going to slide the highlight saturation slider that will determine how much blue I want in the highlights. So something like this looks quite nice if you ask me. And then I'm going to do the same thing with the shadows, but usually when we use a cold color in the highlights, we want to use a warm color in the shadows and vice versa. So I'm going to select this orange yellow color and I'm going to add some saturation over here. All right, let's see if we push it, if you keep pushing. Okay, and let's play around No, maybe. Yes, this looks like an 80s or 90s, let's say, war film, if you ask me. So I'm digging this. This is more like a yellow-green, light-green tone, if you go over here. And if we want to take it to the next level, to create a filmic look, I'm going to click over here, add another final layer, I promise, which is another curves adjustment layer. And I'm going to click and drag this control point upwards to fade everything out. And because I want to keep this faded look, but bring back some contrast, I'm going to click somewhere around here to create a new control point. I'm going to drag it downwards. So there you have it. And now if we want to make it even better, we're going to click here and bring this control point for the midtones to the center of the curves dialog. And this will retain this filmic look, but also allow us to have some nice, bright, medium tones here within the photo. All right, there you go. And there you have it. Now, if you find this kind of photo too colorful, especially here at the part of the face, you can always go over here, select a hue saturation adjustment. So give me a second to find it. Why I'm always having trouble to find a hue saturation? There it is, HSL. You can select, for example, the red colors or the yellow colors, or you can click on the picker and click here. Okay, as you can see, I can click on the picker, click on the face, and it will select all the colors within the range of the skin tones. And if the skin tone becomes too red, sometimes it does, you can go over here and lower the saturation, and now you're good to go. Okay, this is a quick and dirty way to fix over, let's say, saturated colors in skin tones, especially where you do cinematic color grades like this. Now, we can do a lot of things. We can add vignettes, we can play around with sharpness, we can do a whole lot of things, but let's call it a day. This is the before, this is the after, before and after, okay? This is a really interesting color grade. Now, if I would go just a little further to improve this photo, I would probably add some more sharpness over here using, let's say, a filter of where it is sharpened. I would probably use a high pass filter just like this. But in order to do so, okay, let's do this bonus tip, okay, because why not? We can make an 1 hour long video if we want to. The heck with it. So I'm going to select the background call, the background layer. I'm going to hit Control J. I'm going to go to the filters, sharpen. I'm going to select high pass. I'm going to give a radius of around 4.4. I'm going to hit switch to overlay. Okay, and as you can see, before and after, before and after, we have a lot more sharpness. We can see a lot more water coming from upside upwards from beneath the helicopter, etc., etc., and we are really, I think, good to go. Okay, so if you liked this tutorial, you can find at illumis.com a full-blown course on how to create amazing cinematic portraits. It's a full course and it's completely free for you to take and watch as many times as you want. You will find all the details at the link down below. If you watch this on YouTube, you will also find the link down below in the description of this video. You can go register and watch this course completely for free. It's made for Affinity Photo and it will teach you how to create amazing cinematic black and white portraits. Again, if you like this tutorial, give it a thumbs up. You know how much it helps. And until next time, take care. Happy editing. If you have any questions, let me know in the comments down below. And don't forget to subscribe, because each and every week we bring you one or two tutorials like this one. And we are also starting to add some photography tutorials as well that will help you become better photographers overall. Okay, thank you very much. See you on the next one. Ciao.